On 24th October 2059, I was walking with Gong Bilang when suddenly it rained. But it didn't just rain eh. The rain came with a super strong storm that all of a sudden, it blew Gong Bilang away from Jurong all the way to Tampines. I was so angry.
Eh? Why angry?
Because did the weather just fetch me? Yeah, in the last few days, you might have experienced very, very strong stormy rains. These are called Sumatra squalls. So, what are Sumatra squalls and why are they so strong and why do we experience it more nowadays? Watch on, because there's some good news and some bad news. So, what are Sumatra squalls? For a start, you need to know what squalls are. Squall is not a character in Final Fantasy 8, ayo. Squall is basically a very sudden gush of strong wind, normally with rain or even snow in other countries. It kind of must be sudden lah, and it must be rather strong, so strong that your umbrella will feel like a parachute. Sometimes, it's so strong that it can gaga move a pair of pants from Bishan to Amokyo. So, in recent days, you might have experienced strong squalls in Singapore. One happened on 24th October night, and another occurred on 27th October early morning. These are indeed squalls, but they are special squalls called Sumatra squalls. You see, if you have read the news, you'll know that the Meteorological Service Singapore have reported that in the second half of October, there might be Sumatra squalls. So, why are these squalls called Sumatra squalls eh? Don't tell me ah, it's developed in Sumatra, then it fly over to Singapore. Really ah? Yeah, it's that simple lah. Long story cut short, during this period, somewhere at Sumatra gets hot. Then it creates super powerful clouds and winds that slowly move towards the east, which is where Singapore and Malaysia are. So they move and move and move lah, until they get so strong that when they reach Singapore and Malaysia, they have wind gusts of say, even over 80 km per hour. The highest is 144.4 km per hour in 1984 in Singapore. But you also notice something. If you have paid attention earlier, you'll notice that the squalls move from Sumatra to Singapore during the day. This is why usually, the Sumatra squall occur in the early morning to the morning in Singapore, since it's kind of developed in Sumatra. They spend the day and night travelling to Singapore. I know there are cases whereby they happen at night, like the 24 October Sumatra squall, but most occur in Singapore during the early mornings to mornings. But of course, sometimes it does happen earlier, like the one that happened last year on 17 September, whereby the squall lasted from about 7 PM to 8:30 PM. Usually, the west side of the country will kana first, as it's nearer to Sumatra. It can be dangerous. But Gong Bilang won't fly, other things have been flying around during Sumatra squalls in Singapore. For example, for the 17th September 2024 Sumatra squall, many trees fell, disrupting traffic. Some buildings were even damaged. So, will we be seeing more Sumatra squalls? Well, there's good news and bad news. Today's sponsor is Longbridge. While investing to feel less complicated, Longbridge AI power tools can help you navigate the markets with ease. With $0 lifetime commission for the US, Singapore, and Hong Kong markets, plus competitive asset fees, you can keep more of what you earn. Get up to $800 welcome rewards and an additional $18 cash vouchers when you open an account through this QR code or the link in the description. Now, back to the video. Here's the thing, based on the data of the Sumatra squalls from 1988 to 2009, Sumatra squalls usually occur between April to May and October to November. Yes, which is now lah. On average, we might see about 7 squalls a month. In addition, there's something known as the El Nino or La Nina status in Singapore. I know this is chim, but just know that we are often in a certain season at any point in time. One is called El Nino and the other one called La Nina. We are likely going to be in La Nina. And here's the thing, the historical data shows that during the La Nina period, we might have more Sumatra squalls. Having said that, this means that we will see more Gong Bilang flying from Jurong to Tampines in the next few weeks. So what's the good news? Like I said earlier, it usually happens during the early mornings, as data shows that half of Sumatra squalls in Singapore happen between 3 AM to 8 AM, which will turn our nights into a shook night to sleep lah. Now, as to when the next Sumatra squall is coming, no one knows, but we cannot predict one thing. How we use the internet browser is going to be very, very different soon. Watch this and you'll know why you might no longer use Google Chrome next year. Also, follow me on Instagram if you have not done so, as we will publish exclusive short videos there, link in description. And if you want to advertise with us, even as a standalone video, do contact us. Thank you for spending almost 4 minutes with me. I really appreciate it and hope you learned something.